Hello, my friends. Welcome back to my channel. I am super excited about today's video. It's something that I have waited almost a decade to be able to show off. So we are so pumped. But before we get started, I just wanted to quickly tell you guys that John and I, my husband, contracted the vid. So if you hear me sounding nasty, it's because I'm still coming out of it. But I feel much better. I sound worse than I feel is what I'm trying to say. Today's video has been 10 years in the making almost. Well, like 9 years, I'd say. It's the nursery tour for our baby boy who's gonna be here literally any day now. And we're so excited. We knew that we did not need to set up a nursery this early. Like, I know that he's gonna be in a bassinet and not in a crib for a few months, and most of the stuff in the nursery is just, it's not necessary, you know? But guess what? I don't need to hear any of the negative Nancy about it, because this is like a milestone for me to be able to get to decorate and all of that stuff. So that's why we got it done now. So that's why, before I get comments about you didn't need to do all that, you know, just let me have this, okay? It's just more the action of being able to decorate this room. Like, it's just a milestone moment. We went with a Peter Pan themed nursery. And you'll see in the clips here, I'm gonna try and include some clips of like getting the nursery together, kind of like the progress, and then at the end will be a final tour. Okay, so I think that's it. I'm gonna let you guys get to the video. Make sure you like and subscribe before you leave. Okay, you guys, so coming at you with a progress update. This is the nursery. It's got a lot of mess in here now, but it's pretty much done. It's ready for finishing touches. So over here, we have this big, beautiful closet. We went with LifeProof fresh oak flooring, and LifeProof is a luxury vinyl product, so it's not laminate, it's not hardwood, it's its own beast. So we went with fresh oak. It looks lighter in person than it is on the camera, but anyways. And then this beautiful paint color is bare frosted sage. We also replaced the ceiling fan, and we just went with like a white base, and then we decided to do the blades facing down because it's a similar color to the floor. And then next steps in the project is we have a few more outlet covers to hang up over here. We got some done, but not all. We're going to hang up the curtain rod, and then I got these beautiful hunter green curtains to hang up. And then we can start furnishing this bad boy and decorating. Okay, quick little nursery update. We realized that the inside of this window did not get completed. So we did get one blind hung up. We just need to finish painting on the inside. And then we got a curtain rod up. My job today is going to be to vacuum and mop in here. And then we're gonna get, we have a rug and one of those little no slip grip thingies for the rug. This closet is starting to fill up with both decor and baby items. So so my job today is going to be simply to clean this room, and then John is gonna get the dresser built for me so I can start filling all the drawers, washing the clothes we have, all that good stuff.
Thank you. Oops.
Evidence that men do read the instruction manual.
Define read. I use the photos. I don't read anything.
Can we just talk about his hair, everyone?
Listen.
We leave Hawaii and he's just turned into a train wreck. Okay, we're at like a progress point, so I'm gonna give you guys a little update here. Today, we built the dresser. And by we, I mean John. And then we also picked up the changing pad and a cover for the changing pad. I like this cover because it's like the wipeable kind. And then the other thing I like is that it's like the type, it's almost like a fitted sheet. So it's like easy to pop this off. I thought it was gonna like zip around or something and be annoying, but nope. And then I stuck all of our quilts and swaddles that we have so far in here, but I bought organizers for these drawers, so over the next video clips, you'll be seeing me figure that life out. And then tonight, John is going to build this little cubby unit for me. And the idea is the cubby is gonna go right to the left of the changing table, and on the top is gonna have like the wipe warmer and the organization, all that crap. Over here, we have a decor sign that's gonna be going above the diaper changing area because we don't wanna hang anything above the crib, and then this is where the crib's gonna be. So tomorrow, hopefully, we'll put down this rug, get the cubby unit built, and then I have a set of shelves that I wanna go up next to this sign. So hopefully we can accomplish those things. I'll just show you guys the inside of the closet right now. We've been accumulating gifts and decor in here. So this is the current state that you see here. It's just kind of a mess. But I wanted to give you guys a mid-progress point. Okay, this is real life update. The state of the affairs, everything is everywhere. But we did get shelves put up, so victory. We've got the crib mattress came in. We need the crib to be built. I've started folding things. I've been doing laundry. It's a lot. But I want to show you the middle of the process because I feel like people don't do that. John got the crib built. I am so excited about this. We still have this pile of crazy over here that I need to go through. We have curtains, we have blinds, we even have a rug down, still working itself out over here. I've just got random, like these clothes have all been washed. They just need to be folded and put away. This is all stuff that needs to be washed. So that's exciting. And then over here, I feel like this was already washed. Yeah, this is clean. This was already washed. Over here, I need to wash these, and then I bought some boxes to put them in so we can store them like in the far right of the closet because those are like older ages type thing. And just kind of some more random things that we need to go through. We've got a diaper pail, stuff like that. And Stella's inspecting. What do we think? Do we like it for our new bestie? Yes? Yes? Good girl. Okay, so that's it. I just wanted to give you guys a little midpoint update. Thank you. Okay, you guys, let's start over here. So the boring stuff first. I just did like Hunter Green blackout curtains. Just pull across like this so it can get really dark in here. And then we have the blind, so double darkness. And then over here we have the crib. This is a farmhouse style Delta crib. I got it at Target. This is a beautiful quilt that our cousin gifted us through an Etsy shop, and it was on our registry. We loved it. Before anyone says anything, I already know you do not put the quilt in with the child, so don't worry. That's just decorative for right now until we get a glider. This is just hanging out on the crib, but it'll go on the glider, and it's decorative only. I have Burt's Bees organic crib sheets in like, it's like a navy and gray striped type situation. So it kind of went with the whole like nautical Peter Pan situation. Over here, I have this like little nightlight that honestly is more just for decorative purposes than anything. It does let off a little bit of light, but nothing insane. And it has like little stars that go on the wall. And then right here, we got a Frida purifier. It's a sound machine, purifier, and something else all in one. I want to say a nightlight. So we got that. And then next to the crib, I have... these are all swaddles inside here, so all swaddle blankets. I have quilts and like larger blankets. And then down here, I have like tub type things, like the tubby towels that have the hooded stuff on it. So that's kind of like grab and go type situation. Over here, this is probably gonna go in his closet, but this is one of the best purchases I feel like I made. Our laundry room is actually upstairs. This is on wheels. So I can, as I've been prepping this room and washing clothes that we got and all that stuff, I was able to just throw that in there and then just roll it to the laundry room. So that was one of my favorite purchases thus far because the baby isn't here yet, so I can't rate anything else. Over here, one of our friends gifted us these beautiful prints also from Etsy. They're 8x10s and they're just kind of like Neverland type situation with the mermaid lagoon and the ship. So now I'm going to turn you to the right, and over here, these are like my favorite. I got these floating shelves off of Amazon, and then I didn't want to be like too crazy, so I just tried to keep it somewhat minimal, but I don't know. To some people, this might be minimal. To some people, it might be too much. I don't really know. But one of our friends gifted us this adorable Disneyland Paris Peter Pan Mickey, which was perfect. He didn't want to sit down at first, but we forced him. I got just like a clock on Amazon, I want to say. And then I just did some books. So we have obviously Peter Pan. Someone gifted this to us. It's one of the little golden books. So I did that in the back. And then I found this Peter Pan book at Barnes & Noble, actually. And then I got these 20,000 League Under the Seas and Treasure Island because I just felt like it kind of goes with the whole like adventure type theme. And then this is like a little newborn hat. And I got this from Etsy. It's like a felt newborn hat, and I just thought it was so perfect. Up here, I just got this like cheap frame on the left from Target. And then I went on my Silhouette Studio because I have an Etsy shop making vinyl designs and stuff like that. And I just made myself my own little print for there with the quote. I got that Big Ben statue and the pirate ship off of Amazon. Down here, my mother-in-law gifted us this digital print of the I Love You to Neverland and Back. So I just sent it to Vistaprint or something like that to print it in like a larger size. I want to say that's like a 16 by 20. So I love that. And then over here, she also gifted us this watercolor map. And then I bought this for us. It's a watercolor of the Lost Boys. I just thought that was so adorable. Down here, we got the Delta dresser. They didn't have a farmhouse one that matched when we bought it. So I just got, you know, a simple one. Oh, it's all dirty. I just got like a simple one. I didn't really care that much. But inside here, I just bought these little dividers off of Amazon. So they have like different sizes for all of the things you might need. So the way that I set it up for now is this entire top drawer is all newborn items. And then I have 0 to 3 months is in this drawer. And then lastly, 3 to 6 months. I have some in here, and then I have some I'll show you in the closet. So that way I can kind of just move the drawers as needed. I got this changing pad. It's like a waterproof changing pad. I just got it at Target. It was, I don't remember what they called it, but it was like Gray Arrow or something. One of our friends sent us this amazing wipe warmer organization station. I don't really have it organized, so don't judge how it is right now, because I was just kind of throwing things as we got them. But I just put like pacifiers. I have this Tubby Todd ointment stuff that everybody said was great. I got that like Nose Frida thing. I also got a electric version of that. I have like the boogie drops, some of the first aid stuff. And then over here we have like a roll of the diaper bags. We didn't end up going with a Munchkin diaper bag or a Diaper Genie, but I'll show you what we got after. And then I have the little thermometer. I bought a regular thermometer, this thermometer, and a infrared thermometer, so we're good on thermometers. And then just some more first aid stuff back there. And then this is a wipe warmer, so it'll warm the wipes. And then I have newborn diapers in there. I don't know how long he'll be in newborn diapers. Down here, we started his little book collection. Most of these were gifted by people, which is amazing. That little bunny rabbit came with this book right here, the Guess How Much I Love You, which I thought was so adorable. And then in here, I just have like random, like the changing pad liners that's underneath this changing pad zipper thingy. I have extras of those and then just random first aid stuff. The bottom one is completely empty right now. We ended up getting the, is it Ubi diaper pail. So the reason why we got that one was because they didn't use, like you didn't have to use only their liners or something. I don't really remember. It's been a while since I made my choices on purchases. This one, I just have like a random blanket and then refills for the diaper pail. And then down here is burp cloths and bandanas and all that good stuff, bibs. So that is like the decorative walkthrough. Oh, and this rug I got on Wayfair. And it has one of those no slip thingies underneath it. So the reason why this is all empty over here is because I have a mobile that I'm gonna hang right here. And then we're also going to be putting in a glider eventually. And then I'll just show you the closet, but it's nothing really to write home about. It's not really that organized. On the left side, down at the bottom, we have extra wipes and diapers. I have more than that. They're just not in here. I have our upstairs boppy because I have a boppy for upstairs and downstairs. These boxes I got on Amazon. I'm obsessed. So we were gifted like all of his clothes from my two best friends who had babies like a year and 2 years before I did. So, or actually 2 and 3 years before I did. So we were like set on clothes. So I have all of these boxes with the clothes that, like folded, washed, organized by type and all that. So when we're ready, we can just kind of move them where they need to be. And they're all labeled with the sizing. And then back here, I just have like a gift that one of our friends got us. It's like a toy. I don't have anything to do with it yet. This is just kind of like a random box of stuff. And then we got a Dock-A-Tot. This is just an empty extra basket if I need it. Back there is a couple more of the organizers. Then I hung up some clothes that are like the kind that need to be hung up. We don't have like a crazy amount of plans of leaving the house much. So, and they're all separated. I got these dividers on Amazon. So they're all separated with the little dividers. So we have plenty of clothes for little man. And then over here, I decided to start like a little Christmas book collection. I wrote him like a little message inside the Christmas book. I started him off with The Night Before Christmas because I felt like that was just a classic. This was one of my favorites growing up. So that will start his Christmas collection. And then our friend got us these adorable Ray Dunn milestone discs. So these are them. I thought that was great. I thought it was different because I don't know if I'll be able to keep up with the monthly photos, so that's a little bit more attainable. Up top, oh my god, we found these Harry Potter illustrated books on Amazon. They're like pop-up, not pop-up, but they're like super illustrated and awesome. So far they only released the first and second one, but I thought that was a fun collection to start for him. So I put them at the top because I don't want to mix it up with like daily use ones. That's more like when he's older, like 8 or 9. And then over here, I don't know, just random stuff, okay? So anyways, that's his little closet. I think we want to get an organizer because as you can tell, there's just a lot of wasted space right in the middle. And I saw Home Depot sells for like $80, like one of those like closet organizers that has the cubbies that go down the center with drawers. And I think for children, that just makes more sense. Not even just newborns, but just as they grow older. So we'll probably do that eventually, but I'm not stressing about it now. So that is the entirety of the nursery. I cannot believe I finally made this video because it feels like this has been in progress. And it's still in progress, but at least it's mostly done. So that's it. Okay, you guys, thank you so much for coming along for our nursery tour. We are so incredibly grateful for all the love and support we've got, all of the gifts that were given to us from our registry, and just random gifts that you guys thought of that I couldn't have that have been gifted to us. It just means truly so much. We cannot wait to meet our little prince and look forward to having many, many memories in that little nursery with him. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you subscribe before you leave if you want more of these, and I will talk to you later. Bye. Nala says bye as well. Goodbye.